Right. Now we shall see an example based on the indefinite integration where partial fractions are involved and provided q of x has repeated linear factors. And remember carefully, here always degree of p of x is less than degree of q of x. Now if you could observe carefully, 3x minus 2 is one linear factor and x plus 1 is also a linear factor, but repeated for 2 times. So what I'll be doing means, I will consider the given function. What is the given function? Let 3x minus 5 divided by 3x minus 2 into x plus 1 whole square. So partial fraction shall be writing totally one, this particular factor is repeated for 2 times and this is another linear factor. So we need how many constants? 3 constants. So what happens? A by 3x minus 2 plus B by x plus 1 plus C by x plus 1 whole square. So finally, what I'll be doing, that implies 3x minus 5 is equal to, if I take LCM, I think everything will be getting cancelled, A into, so here comes what, x plus 1 whole square plus B into x plus 1 into 3x minus 2 plus C into, comes here 3x minus 2. So now I need to calculate the value of A, B, C. For calculating the value of A, B, C, for my convenience, I'll be putting x is equal to minus 1. If I put x is equal to minus 1, what happens? LHS becomes 3 into minus 1 minus 5. So that becomes minus 8. This becomes 0 because x ki jagah mein minus 1 rakhe to a 0 aa jayega. And this also becomes 0 and this becomes C into minus 3 minus 2. So finally what happened? I think this becomes minus 5, here minus 8, minus 8, minus minus will be getting cancelled. So what happens? 8 is equal to 5C. So what happens? C, I will be getting it as 8 by 5. So I got the value of C. So now later what I will be doing? I want to find the value of B, so, or some other value of A. For that, what I'll be doing, I'll be putting x is equal to 2 by 3 because 3x minus 2 is there. As 3x minus 2 is there, I'll put 3x minus 2 is equal to 0 means x is equal to 2 by 3. So this part becomes 0, this part becomes 0 and this doesn't become 0. So from that I can get the value of A. So what happens, that becomes 3 into, in place of x, I'll be writing 2 by 3 minus 5 is equal to, in place of a, I'll be writing it as 2 by 3 plus 1 whole square. So here 3, 3 will be getting cancelled. 2 minus 5 means minus 3 is equal to 2 by 3 plus 1. 2 by 3 plus 1 is 5 by 3. 5 by 3 whole square means it becomes as A into 25 by 9. So what happens? That implies cross multiplication. This becomes minus 27. So here what I'll be getting? A is equal to minus 27 by 25. Now I got the value of C. I got the value of A. But finally I need to find the value of B. For finding the value of B, I will suggest you one thing. You put x is equal to 0. So that we'll be getting an expression in terms of a plus b plus c. So our method also becomes easy. So what I'll be getting? Put x is equal to 0. If I put x is equal to 0, LHS becomes minus 5. This becomes a, because a into 0 plus 1 whole square is 0. I kept x is equal to 0. So LHS I got minus 5 and 0 plus 1 whole square means I got as a. And here also if you could observe carefully, x ki jagah mein 0 rakhe to b into 0 plus 1 into 0 minus 2. So this becomes a minus 2b, x ki jagah mein 0 substitute kare to. Here also when I substitute x is equal to 0, that becomes minus 2c. So finally what happens? That implies minus 5 is equal to, in place of a, minus 27 by 25 and minus 2b, and in place of c 2 into 8 by 5 means 16 by 5. So finally, what happens? We should be very, very careful in calculations. Minus 5. I think everywhere I will cancel minus. So what happens? 5 is equal to 27 by 25 plus 16 by 5. So 27 by 25 plus 16 by 5 plus 2b. So finally, what happens? That implies 5 is equal to, here 25 is LCM. So 27 plus 80. 27 plus 80 means 107. 107 by 25 plus 2b. So finally, what happens here? I am writing the value of b. So what happens? 2b is equal to 5 minus 107 by 25. So again, LCM is 25. 25, 25 is a 125. 125 minus 107. 125 minus 107 is 18. 18 by 25. But here this is 2b. 2b is equal to 18 by 25. So what happens? B is equal to 9 by 25. So if you could observe carefully, I got the value of A, I got the value of B, and I got the value of C. So directly, I need to substitute in this particular expression. So I think if you copy all these things, I'll be substituting here. So please copy. Right, now I'll be substituting. So in place of A, what I'll be writing? In place of A, I'll be writing minus 27 by 25. Later, in place of B, what I'll be writing? 9 by 25. And in place of C, what I'll be writing? 8 by 5. So finally, I need to do integration. How will be? Integration means apply integral on both the sides. So therefore, integral of 3x minus 5 by x minus 2 into x plus 1 whole square is equal to integral of nothing is there, means here clearly understood it is dx. I am not writing every time. So minus 27 by 25, there remains 1 by 3x minus 2 dx, and here 9 by 25 into 1 by x plus 1 dx plus 8 by 5 into integral of 1 by x plus 1 whole square dx. So finally, what happens? Minus 27 by 25 integral of, it is like 1 by x. 1 by x means log mod 3x minus 2, but whatever coefficient of x is there, that comes to denominator, and here 9 by 25. Integral of 1 by x plus 1 means log mod x plus 1, and here also it is like 1 by x square. 1 by x square means minus 1 by x. So minus 8 by 5 into x plus 1 on the whole c. So any cancellation is there, means we can do it. So here 3 1s are 3 9s are. So finally, what happens? Minus 9 by 25 minus 9 by 25. Or else what I'll be doing means, just I'll write 9 by 25. Here it is like log m minus log n. So log of x plus 1 by 3x minus 2 minus 8 by 5 into x plus 1 plus c. Now, we shall be seeing problems based on application of partial fractions in indefinite integration, where denominator means, here I call it as q of x, involves some quadratic factors. I'll go by an example. Always remember, here degree of numerator should be less than degree of denominator. So degree of numerator should be less than degree of denominator. So here, if suppose p of x by quadratic factor means x square plus x plus 1 is there, into some linear factor x plus 1. So how can you write this particular function ka partial fractions, means forgets about for some time about this particular integral symbol, x square plus x plus 1. I think this is irreducible. Irreducible means where we cannot factorize. Whenever we are not able to factorize, for that particular quadratic expression, the partial expression should be taken as ax plus b divided by x square plus x plus 1, and another constant for this particular linear factor, and this should be taken as c upon x plus 1. This is a rule and you should remember. I'll go by another example. Example 2. If suppose p of x divided by this time x square minus x minus 7 into again here x square 3x square minus 2x minus 25, like this is there. And if suppose another one x plus 10 is there. Here we are having how many quadratic expressions? This is a quadratic expression, this is a quadratic expression, this is a linear expression. Corresponding to this particular quadratic expression, I will take ax plus b divided by x square minus x minus 7. And again, corresponding to this particular second quadratic expression, I need to write a partial fraction of the same form but with different constants. So cx plus d divided by 3x square minus 2x minus 25. And the last one is linear. Linear means we need to take only one constant. So e upon x plus 10. I think by this time you are well aware of writing the partial fractions, and then after writing the partial fractions you can integrate. So now we are going to do a problem based on this pattern. Right, now we shall go by a problem. Here the function is given as x upon x square plus 1 into x plus 1. Here this is a quadratic part and this is a linear part. So I'll consider the function. Consider x upon x square plus 1 into x plus 1. So here quadratic is there. So partial fraction will become as ax plus b divided by x square plus 1. And this is a linear one. So for this I'll write as c by x plus 1. So that implies I will take LCM. So x is equal to ax plus b into x plus 1 plus c into x square plus 1. I will call this as 1. So now I want to find the values of a, b, c. For finding the values of a, b, c, what I'll be doing? At beginning I'll put x is equal to minus 1. If I put x is equal to minus 1, definitely this part will become 0. And this part will become minus 1 whole square plus 1. That means 2c. So minus 1 is equal to, that becomes 2c. That means what happens? C is equal to minus 1 by 2. So I got the value of c equal to minus 1 by 2. But I need to find the values of a and b. How can I find the values of a and b? That is more logical thing. So for this, what I'll be doing means, if I put x is equal to 0, we shall see what happens. If I put x is equal to 0, I think this particular a will be vanishing, this particular will be vanishing, and here also will be getting vanishing. That means x will be getting vanishing. So we are getting, so what I'll be doing, put x is equal to 0. If I put x is equal to 0, left hand side will become 0. So a into 0 will be 0. So b into 0 plus 1 will be b, and c into 0 plus 1 will be c. So I got 0 is equal to b plus c, but c is nothing but minus half. Coming to this side, b will be coming as 1 by 2. So later, again, I want to calculate the value of a. How can we find the, or how can we calculate the value of a means? If you could observe carefully, here x is there, but here x square is there. So I think I can compare the coefficient of x square. So if I compare coefficient of x square on both sides, compare x square on both the sides. Both the sides means here LHS and RHS. In LHS there is no part called x square. So definitely LHS I should take as 0. And here x square means AX into X. So there I am getting A. And C x square. So I should take as C. Compare x square means here comparing coefficient of x square. So what happens? 0 is equal to A plus C. So here again A equal to minus C. But C is nothing but minus half. So A I got as half. See very beautifully. Bahut pyara tarike se aaya. A is equal to 1 by 2. So I got A as 1 by 2, B as 1 by 2, C as minus 1 by 2. So I can substitute in our equation 1. So definitely what happens? Therefore, 1 implies x upon x square plus 1 into x plus 1 is equal to, in place of A, I will go for 1 by 2. That means it becomes x by 2. In place of B also 1 by 2 whole divided by x square plus 1, and in place of C I'll be writing minus 1 by 2 divided by x plus 1. So now I need to integrate. So x by x square plus 1 into x plus 1 dx, and I think 1 by 2 is common, so 1 by 2 I will take outside. So there remains x plus 1 by x square plus 1 dx minus 1 by 2 into 1 by x plus 1 dx. Now if you could observe carefully on left hand side, x plus 1 by x square plus 1 is there. So we should be very very careful. I think this I can split like this, x by x square plus 1 dx plus 1 by 2 into 1 by x square plus 1 dx minus 1 by 2 into 1 by x plus 1 dx. Now here this particular integral we can go by substitution method. That means put x square plus 1 is equal to t. So 2x dx is equal to dt. X dx is equal to dt by 2. I think this I will show it in rough. In a small way I am writing x square plus 1 is equal to t. 2x dx is equal to dt. X dx means dt by 2. So here definitely what I'll be doing, 1 by 2 in place of x dx I will write as dt by 2, and x square plus 1 I will write as t. And here 1 by 2 integral of 1 by x square plus 1 tan inverse x minus 1 by 2 log mod x plus 1 plus c. So what happens here? 1 by 4 integral of 1 by t means log mod t. Log mod t, but t is nothing but what? X square plus 1 plus 1 by 2 tan inverse x minus 1 by 2 log mod x plus 1 plus c. I think the problem is finished. Up till now, we have seen various kinds of patterns in indefinite integration. Now, we shall see problems based on integral of dx by ax square plus bx plus c, integral of dx by under root of ax square plus bx plus c, integral of under root of ax square plus bx plus c dx. I'll be telling how to do those problems, but before doing those problems, once again I will give a quick review of the very very important problems we had done in our previous class, but you should remember now this as a formula. So you can repeat with me. Integral of 1 by a square plus x square dx means 1 by a tan inverse x by a plus c, and integral of dx by under root of a square minus x square is equal to sine inverse of x by a plus c, integral of dx by under root of x square minus a square is equal to log mod x plus under root of x square plus a square plus c, and integral of dx by under root of a square plus x square is equal to log mod x plus under root of x square plus a square plus c. Here it is x square minus a square. Now this just now we have done in today's class, we have developed this formula using partial fractions. Integral of dx by a square minus x square is equal to 1 by 2a log mod a plus x by a minus x, and dx by x square minus a square is equal to 1 by 2a log mod x minus a by x plus a. Right. Now, if suppose a problem is given to you like this, evaluate integral of dx by x square plus x plus 1d. How you need to do? We need to observe carefully what is given in our denominator, x square plus x plus 1. So, what I suggest you means, I suggest you to go by this method called as a method of squaring. What is coefficient of x here? You please observe carefully. Coefficient of x is what here? 1. You divide it by 2. So, comes what? 1 by 2. Now you square. So what happens? 1 by 2 whole square. 1 by 2 whole square ka value is 1 by 4. So what I suggest you means add this particular 1 by 4 and subtract this particular 1 by 4 to the given expression. So what happens? X square plus x plus 1 by 4 plus 1 minus 1 by 4. If you could observe carefully, this is like a x plus 1 by 2 whole square. And 1 minus 1 by 4 is what? 3 by 4. So definitely what happens? The total expression had become as x square plus x plus 1 had become as x plus 1 by 2 whole square plus 3 by 4. So what happens? Our problem will turn down to dx divided by x plus 1 by 2 whole square plus 3 by 4. 3 by 4 means again I can write as dx divided by x plus 1 by 2 whole square. This particular 3 by 4 I can write as root 3 by 2 whole square. Now if you could observe carefully, it is like dx by x square plus a square. Dx by x square plus a square means I can apply this particular formula. What is the formula? 1 by a tan inverse of x by a plus c. So 1 by a means a ki jagah mein kya hai humko? Root 3 by 2 tan inverse of x by a. X by a means here x ki jagah mein x plus 1 by 2 divided by root 3 by 2 plus c. Always remember, whenever this kind of problem is given, we need to turn this particular thing into perfect square. Perfect square means rounding to the nearest square. That means just now I said x ka coefficient 1 and divide by 2. Make it whole square. That particular result you should add and subtract.